So good morning once again. Let's go ahead today and discuss this module number 3, which talks about classes, objects, and constructors. Now, when you actually try to think in an object-oriented manner, say for example, everything in Java is actually an object. Not only in Java, but then in any programming language that you will be using in the future, everything is an object. So, for example, in Java, yung keyword natin na public, yung keyword natin na static, yung mga ganyan, void, everything is actually an object. And an object is basically a member of a class. Diba? So, we have a public class, the name of the class. And each class here, we have a main method. And each, alam naman natin na ang main method is basically the execution point of any programming language. Diba? Now, you can probably think of an inanimate physical items as an object. For example, ito. Yun, literal, diba? Your desk, your computer, your keyboard, anything. Basically, yung mga yan, objects yan. Even living things, yan, nakikita nyo dito, diba? Even living things are considered as objects. Ayan. Now, events are also objects, especially in Java. Hindi pa kasi tayo nagkakaroon ng event in Java programming, pero later on, so for example, sa SAP 12B, pag next year, pagdating natin siguro sa face-to-face classes, I'm going to introduce to you what we call the events. Events are also objects, yan. Pero in literal terms, for example, ito, the stock purchase you made, the mortgage closing you attended, and everything, yan, yung mga yan, are objects. And, for you to understand objects, you have to differentiate them between a class and an object. Later on, magkakaroon tayo ng iba't ibang klase ng program discussing the implementation of classes and different objects as well. So, introduce ko rin sa inyo yung tinatawag natin na constructors and how it plays a big role in any object-oriented programming. Okay? So, an object, take note, is an instantiation of a class or one tangible example of a class. Now, when I say instantiate, for example, alright, ginagamit kasi ang word na instantiate if you would like to create. Okay? If you would like to create a new object, or particularly in, so for example, in Java, when I say instantiate, you are trying to create a particular object in which you will be calling in some parts of the code. In game development, para mas maintindihan natin ang word na instantiate, it's actually the way on how you spawn or you create a particular like physical object in your game spaces. Yan, object na. Pag sinabi kasi natin objects, it can also be a members of more than one class. For example, yan, your goldfish is not just a fish, but also a vertebrate. And also an animal at the same time. And meron tayong tinatawag kasi na topic na introduction to inheritance. And from the word itself, inheritance, you are inheriting the properties of a specific object. In Java programming, say for example, you have a particular class. And each classes has its own unique properties, and those properties can be inherited by another class depende kung ano yung gagawin mo sa code mo. Okay? And the concept of a class is very useful because of its reusability. Objects can gain their attributes or properties, should I say, from their classes, and all objects have predictable attributes because they are members of a certain classes. Ito, pag sa object-oriented programming natin or the OOP terms, sometimes you create classes so that you can instantiate objects from them. And other times, you create classes to run as application. In Java kasi, especially in oriented programming language, instantiating an object is just simply by adding the keyword new. Mga yan, new as in bago. Pero mamaya natin pag-uusapan yan pag nandun na tayo mismo sa ating code demo. Okay? And application classes frequently instantiate objects that use the objects of other classes and their data methods. Yeah, and often you will write programs that uses classes created by others. So far, what we actually know, yung ginagawa natin na, or ginagamit natin na object, ito, especially in your CP11A, we have used the system class, yung system.out.println, di ba? So, ginagamit natin ng system class in order for us to particularly print something. You know, you didn't have to create it or its print line method. Usually kasi once you access, say for example dito sa program natin, etong system class na to, maybe you are wondering, ano nga ba to? The system here is an object. And the system actually belongs to a specific Java package. And say for example nandito yan sa java.language. Ayan, that system. So, anything na makikita po natin dito sa loob ng system, okay, that also includes the print line method. Let's try to click on the system that, ito, itong system na to na keyword. System alone is class. Take note, ha? It's an object. It is a separate class. And this particular class here already have its value, or should I say attributes or properties. One of them is print line. Etong mga to, built-in na to. Hindi na natin to kailangan gawin sa Java. Kasi, the good thing about this one is it's already included in what we call the Java development kit. We don't need to do this, like, tingnan nito ha, 500 lines of code na, di ba? Napakahaba. Yan. The Java programming language is actually built from ground up, meaning kinode talaga yan isa-isa para makapag produce ng specific output. And one of them alone is sa loob pa lang ng system. Diba? So system is being imported from the java.language that system. So instead of us doing some coding dito na napakahaba-haba, diba? Tatawagin mo na lang itong mismong si system class and the out class, including the print line method, di ba? Tapos nandito na yan. Even the print line method here also belongs to the print stream that Java. Ito, print stream na tinatawag natin. Ayan na, print line. Di ba? Kung titignan mo, this alone is actually an object. In Java, tinatawag lang talaga natin siya. Diba? So, yun po yun. Yun yung magiging parang concept natin ng programming here. We will try to create an object or a new class, and we will try to call them and implement them to other parts of our code. Diba? So, yan. If may pangarap kayo na makagawa or makadevelop ng isang programming language, say for example, yan. Ano kayo magiging pangalan ng programming language based sa gusto nyo, diba? So, in order for you to at least achieve that, you have to know how to create a program that, of course, that can fully, you know, that can simply have an object-oriented programming and, you know, you can implement it fully. Kasi para syempre, kapag ka meron ka ng programming language na sarili, magbibigay ka na rin ng mga keywords sa kanila na, oh, ganito ang pag-print. Diba? And so on. Ayan. So, you can call an application or class that instantiates an object of another class, what we called class client or class user. And so far, diba, yan, you can identify a class that is an application because it contains, and we already know this, the public static void main method. It is basically the execution point of your program. And you will write and use many classes that do not contain a main method. Ito. So, later on, magpapakita tayo dito ng sample code. I will be presenting here a sample problem in which somehow related to your activity. And from that particular activity, we have to understand and you guys have to be very aware on how it works. Kasi gagawa tayo ng classes ngayon na wala ng main method. Naka-separate yung main method natin. Okay? So, wait lang ha. Ayan. Asan na ako? Ito. A Java application can contain only one method with the header public static void. And if you write a class that imports another class in both classes, and both classes have a public main method, your application will not compile. Take note, kapag gagawa po kasi tayo ng isang program, we should only have one main method, whatever happens. If you have two main methods, that means you should have two different programs. One main method is responsible for any class na i-execute niya. Tandaan po natin yan, ha? One main method. Pero we can have multiple methods, such as your predefined user methods. And so far, alam na natin kung paano gumamit ng methods. I hope you already know how to do that because I'm assuming na napanood na natin yung mga videos or yung videos natin last week. Because basically, with, you know, having that kind of knowledge from last week is very vital po sa magiging examples natin today or magiging code demo natin for today. And the way on how you understand class and how objects are instantiated from them is the heart of object-oriented thinking. We have to be very familiar and should I say, kailangan ma-expert natin ang object-oriented programming concept. Because after this course that we have here, the CP11B, your CP12A, CP12B particularly, which is, I'll still be your teacher, of course. Yung mga next part ng code natin, gagamitan ko na talaga ng object-oriented programming. Most of the time. Okay, so it's very important for us to be very familiar or at least yung mga terms lang natin na gagamitin. Not only the way how you code, pero syempre, importante rin yun. But then the terms, when I say method, for example, when I say class, when I say objects, when I say constructors, instantiating, yung mga ganyan. So you should be very familiar with them. Okay, so when we create a class ha, ito yan. You must assign a name to the class and you must determine what data and methods will be part of the class. And we already know how to at least create a class, diba? Yung keyword natin na public and yung keyword natin na class. And the name of the class itself, which is the same with the file name. So for example, you decide to create a class named employee. One instance variable of employee might be an employee number. And two necessary methods might be a method to set or provide a value. And the employee number and another method to get or retrieve that employee number. Now, the class here or the class header have three different parts. So kung nakikita niyo itong public class employee na ito, number one is an optional access specifier. Number two is the keyword class. And number three is any legal identifier you choose for the name of your class, starting with an uppercase. And it's very conventional po na i-start natin ang pangalan ng class by, you know, in uppercase. So when I say optional access specifier, based on the discussion last week, it's actually the keyword public, private, static. I mean private, yung mga ganyan, protected. So far, we already know that public, ito kasi yung madalas natin ginagamit, diba, public. It simply means that the public, all of the attributes, okay, or this entire class itself can be accessed by another class that is connected to your program. Kaya yung tinawag na public. When I say private naman, or the private class, that particular class can only be accessed inside. Okay, pero kapag ako napansin nyo dito, we have here a private int. We have a data type and followed by the variable. Diba? This time, you are just telling the entire program that the empnum is a private value. Meaning, it's a static value. Hindi siya nababago. And can only be accessed dito lang sa loob ng public class employee. Although the public class employee can be accessed by anyone, that means hindi ibig sabihin na even the empnum can be accessed as well. It can only access the attribute sa loob lang ng employee. Kaya yan naka-private. Okay? So, maiintindihan natin yan, makikita natin yung power na mga yan. And importante po na meron tayong mga ganito. But then, take note, it's an optional access specifier. If you are not sure what to place, you can just simply remove the public, the private, or the protected, and just simply proceed with the word class. As simple as that. So, pwedeng-pwede po yan. Pero, again, the most liberal form of access is public. And it's a class modifier or access specifier. And as I have said, it is accessible by all objects. It can be extended, by the way, or used as a basis for any other classes. When I say extended, you can just simply use extends keyword. Say, for example, halimbawa, dito sa public class test sandwich na to, meron akong halimbawang isang object na gagawin or ginawa, I can just simply use the keyword extends and the name of the class na ginawa ko rin. For example, hello. The hello object here might contain some particular codes in which I can access later on. So, possible po yun. Okay, kaya nga, you are simply extending the entire class. So, meron pong ganyan. Okay? Ito, again, pwede nyo pong tanggalin si keyword na public. It will still run if you are not sure. Pero, importante na merong optional or the access specifier na meron tayo. And, after writing the class header, you will write the body of the entire, of the employee class between a set of curly braces. Dito. Yan. And they are actually referred to what we call data fields sa loob nito. The figure shows that the data field empnum is not preceded by the keyword static, meaning, yan, only one empnum value would be shared by all employee objects. Yan yung sinasabi ko kanina. So basically, hinuulitin ko lang, humbabasahin ko lang ulit ito. Okay? Pero when we say private access, ito, itong private access, no other classes can access the field's values and only methods of the same class are allowed to set or get. And the principle used in creating private access is what we called information hiding. Again, paggagamit tayo ng private, kasi nga, para lang dito yan, ang empnum is para lang sa employee. Yun yung tinatawag natin na information hiding. You are trying to hide some particular variables. Okay? And, yun nga, private data kasi yan. It can be changed or manipulated only by the class's own method. So, whatever things or whatever methods na inilagay mo dito kay public class employee, yun. Yun yung pagka naka-private. Yun lang ang nagmamayari doon. Okay? So, I hope we are slowly, you know, getting the concept of classes here. Let's try to move on and go to what we call the creating instance methods in a class. Instance. Now, besides the data fields, classes can contain method. Ito, kung nakikita nyo dito tong example natin, the public void set empnum with a, of course, with an int emp sa loob. Diba? Tapos public int get empnum. May term dyan na tinatawag natin. Okay? In which we will discuss later on. This is actually the mutator and accessor method na tinatawag. Now, for example, ito, one method you need for an employee class that contain is an empnum is the method to retrieve. Yun, yung may tinatawag natin na get kasi nga you are trying to retrieve some particular values. And a reasonable name for this method is what we call the getEmpNum. Instead of us putting just simply the word EmpNum or the variable EmpNum, we can just simply put here the keyword or the word get. Kasi nga, you are trying to retrieve a value from the method itself. And its declaration is public int getEmpNum. Ayan. So similarly, you need a method which to set the emp num, and by simply adding the word set nito, its declaration will now be public. Okay. Ang tawag kasi natin dito is what we call mutators and accessors. Take note ha. Mutators are actually the methods that simply set. Sila po yung nagsaset lang ng value. Accessor are just simply the methods that retrieves the values. Retrieve. Accessor. Yung kumbaga in Java programming, ito yung tinatawag natin set-get method. May taga-set, okay, may taga-get. Yung set method na to, limbawa, may main method ka dito sa loob. The set method will eventually, okay, will be eventually called, and a value will be thrown to the send emp na method, in which later on, kapag ka magpiprint na, igiget mo or kukunin mo to, tatawagin mo tong method na to, the getEmpNum method, and will now return a particular value based from what you have set earlier in the mutator na tinatawag natin. So, halimbawa dito, meron kang employee.setEmpNum tapos sa loob 10000. So, yun yung 1000 na yun, magiging emp na, and the value will be empNum, or the variable that stores the value will be empNum, which will now be called in this method, getEmpNum. I know this is still vague, pero mamaya makikita natin yan. Now, the static methods, those methods used with object instantiations are what we call instance methods. You can just go ahead and read the following here, especially the static and non-static. Basically, when we are trying to declare a field and method, a static, and it is very important for us to know the difference between them. Kasi, medyo mali dito kayo eh. Kasi kapag ka gusto nyo lang na gawing static ang isang field, you can just simply put the word static, meaning it's not changeable already. However, kapag ka non-static, you don't need to put any keyword. Okay, you know, you don't need to put any keyword, just simply proceed. Nakakalito yan, pero mamaya magkakaroon tayo ng example dyan. Now, let's try to take a look here at the figure. We have the public class, test class, diba? This figure, it is simply showing how the public, private, static, and non-static class members can be used by another class. The figure shows a class named MyClass, ito, diba? That contains four methods, which are public, static, private static, and public static. Ayan, so meron na tayong mga yan. Try natin siyang intindihin. Okay? And the entire test class contains 8 different method. Ayan, 8 different method calls, in which meron tayong 3 valid and the rest are invalid, which tignan natin kung bakit. Okay. Let's try to take a look here at the public class, test class. We already know that this is an entire class na ginawa natin. However, you will notice here a my class object is equal to my class. Ito. Anong ibig sabihin na itong part na to? This is actually the way on how you instantiate an object, itong part na to. You are trying to instantiate an object. So basically, once you are trying to instantiate this object here, meaning, gagawin mo rin to as a separate class in the program. Saan po ito makikita? Ito yun. This object my class contains 4 different, okay, you know, 4 different methods in such as public, private, diba? I mean public static, and public and private, diba? And now, each attributes here inside the my class are being called. Ito, the public non-static method can be used from test class with a my class object. Ito, parang ito, you are trying to call here the named object with a specific method. Object that pub non stat method, meaning you are trying to call this. And this alone is a legitimate call. It's a valid call. Kasi nga, you are calling the pub non stat method, which is in public. Kasi nga, can be accessed by the entire public class. Itong object.pubstat method naman, itong public static naman na to, ito, again, this is a legal call. Legal. Valid call. Kasi nga, public yan. Ayan na. Public static method can be used from test class with or without an object. Itong myClass.pubstat method, meaning you are trying to call the myClass object, which is ito ulit. This time, you are trying to call the pubstat method. Ayan. Or public stat method naman. Itong public stat method. And this alone is a valid call from this class. So, lagi gets nyo ba? Yung kagaya nga ng sinasabi ko kanina, di ba? Pagka meron kayong public na keyword, meaning it can be accessed by anything. Pero kung titignan natin itong part ng code na to, ito, you are not allowed to call the private stat method, which is this one, private stat method, ito, ang pangalawa. You are not allowed to call that. Bakit? Because it is private, meaning it can only be accessed inside this entire class. Tanda po natin yan, ha? Can only be accessed by this entire class. Same goes through with this private non-static method, which is ito. It can only be accessed by this class, not in this class itself. So I hope you are actually getting the idea of object-oriented programming. Magtanong na kayo, ha, if you are having some difficulties trying to grasp the idea behind this. If you notice as well, medyo binabagalan ko ang discussion kasi this is purely concept. And before tayo mag-code, kailangan nating maintindihan muna kung paano siya nag-gumagana. Okay? Now, this figure here, tingnan natin. Let's try to analyze this figure. We have here a public class employee. Okay? And inside the public class employee, we have here the private empnum, which is basically a variable that can only be accessed directly inside the class employee. However, you are seeing here the accessor and mutator. Ano nga ba ulit yun? Mutators are the set, accessors are the get. Mutators, set, accessors are the get. So you are trying to set a value, and you are also trying to get that value from the setted value, or from the set method as well. So ganun siya. And here on this part, let's try to organize them. And because most classes that you created have multiple data fields, such as empnum, emplastname, yung mga ganyan. And in addition to requiring an employee number, an employee needs a last name, a first name, and a salary as well. So, unti-unti nang nakukompleto, di ba? Unti-unti na natin nakukompleto. And by organizing the data fields inside a classes, it can actually give you a much wider scope kung ano nga ba ang nangyayari sa program mo. Because especially in game development kasi, the good example for or good application of object-oriented programming for me is game development. Especially, literally, if you are trying to create an object in a game, you have to make sure that that object belongs to a specific class that can only be accessed or can only work with a specific class. Say, for example, gusto mo mag-spawn ng sword. Diba? Gusto mo mag-spawn ng sword. Can the sword be a public sword? No. That sword can be a private, cannot be a public sword unless you are really trying to allow anyone in the game to use the sword, including the AI itself. So therefore, the sword must be a private, okay? A private thing or a private class kasi nga, it can only be accessed by either your character, kung sino lang yung may hawak ng sword na yun, not by anything. Diba? So, but not by anyone. So, napaka-importante talaga na maintindihan natin ang concept ng object-oriented. Diba? So, yun yun. It's also the way on how you organize the classes. Ito. Tignan natin itong part ng code natin ito. So, you have here, this is still not an entirely complete program. The complete program is somehow nandito. Pero try na rin natin siyang i-code. Okay? Try na rin natin siyang i-code and try na rin natin na intindihin kung ano nga ba ang nangyayari dito. Let's try to create here a lagay ko muna to dito. Nakikita pa ba? Hindi na, no? Taas ko na lang muna. Ibaba, I mean. Yan, minimize lang muna natin. And, try natin gumawa ng program na yon. Okay, let's try to analyze what is happening sa loob ng code na yon. So, first of all, let's create here a class name with the name employee. Yan. So, an employee. Ibig sabihin, this is actually a program where we will try to create a class employee with its data fields and attributes. So, an employee here should have, number one, an employee number. Tama? And an employee number is not public. Kasi ang isang employee number, parang ID number nyo, pareho. I mean, it's actually unique. Walang dapat kapareho. Diba? Kaya nga, private. So, gagawin natin yung private. So, corresponding with the employee number is the last name of that particular employee. So, ganun din. So, if you have a unique number, probably you will be having a unique last name corresponding to that employee. However, kapag ka ito naka-public, ibig sabihin, there is a possibility na there is a one employee with different last name, which is impossible. Tama? Impossible na magkaroon ng one employee with different last names. So, this should be private. Yan. Ganun din, gawin nating private string employee first name. And this time, the salary. Diba? So, for the salary, we can also consider that as a private. Kasi we want the salary to be accessed inside only the employee. Now, for each particular data fields here, the emp last name, emp first name, emp number, yung mga ganyan, emp salary, maglalagay tayo ng tinatawag natin na accessors and mutators, the set get method na tinatawag natin. So, nandito na tayo sa part ng code natin in which we are trying to create a program with a fully working object-oriented programming concept. So, gawa tayo dito ng public int get epnum. Okay? We are trying to get the value. This is a method, ha? So, anong i-return natin? Whatever value na binato kay epnum. Pero take note, get lang yan. Hindi pa natin siya totally isiniset. So, we can do that by simply putting here a void. Okay, when I say void, meaning you are trying to return, or you are trying to at least, pagka void, meaning wala kang sinusubukang i-return, tama? Pagka walang void, you are trying to return a specific value. Kapag void, wala. So, whatever things na ilalagay mo dito sa loob, yan, will now be stored in the emp num variable. So, mamaya, magbabato ko dito ng value. Tatawagin ko itong si set emp num. Babatuhan ko yun ng value. So, whatever value na ilalagay ko kay set emp num will be stored directly to the emp first and will be stored in the emp num. So, magkakaroon na ng value. Diba? So, ganun din sa last name. We have here the mutators, we can just simply return the last name. Same goes through with the setters. Public void. Oops. Sent emp last name and ganyan. Diba? So, ang babato ko dito is the name, which is, this should be the name. Okay. Ayan, diba nawala na yung red? So, okay na tayo dito sa, okay na tayo dito sa set ng emp num. Next is the get or the, eto, sa employee last name. Proceed naman tayo ngayon sa first name. So basically, pareho lang. Copy-paste ko yan. Pero gawin kong emp first name. Palitan ko to. Gawin ko lang emp first name. Ayan. Ganun din dito. Emp first name. This should be emp first name. Ayun. Tama ba? Emp first name. Get emp first name. Ayun. Emp first name. So, okay na, diba? So, we were able to get the employee first name. Ayan. We are trying to return them. And before that, sineset na rin natin siya. And lastly, the last data field here is the employee salary. Take note ha, each data fields, ginagawan ko ng accessors and mutators. So, meron tayo ditong public double get m salary, which can be accessed or should return a value. Ayan. Together with the public void set m salary, we can just simply name that as like that. Sal. Yan. Alright, so far, we were able to create this entire public class employee with the following data field. So, continue natin yan. Kasi, of course, we know so far that it won't really work because it's still missing one part of the code, which is basically the main method na tinatawag natin. So, titingnan natin yan. Try natin pagganahin yung code natin later on kung ano magiging itsura kapag ka may main method na. Or ano magiging output kapag may main method na. Now, this part of the class here, or the module, the you do it, I really suggest na kung hindi nyo maintindihan yung pinagsasabi ko dito, it's actually better if umpisahan nyo pong panoorin itong you do it classes. Or you do it part ng code natin. It's actually basically the explanation or sample codes na meron tayo per discussion. Okay? Now, let's try to take a look here on how we declare objects and use their methods. So far kasi, we already set them. We already created a class that simply works as the way on how we intended that to work. May accessors and mutators tayo. But then, kagaya ng sabi ko, hindi pa to gagana kasi wala pang main method. Alright? Now, declaring a class does not create any actual objects. A class is just an abstract description of what an object will be like if any objects are ever actually instantiated. A two-step process creates an object that is an instance of a class. Number one is to simply supply what we call a type and identifier. Just like every time na gumagawa tayo ng, or nagde-declare tayo ng variable, di ba? So, you particularly choose a name for it. Tapos, di ba, meron kang data type, meron kang variable, and you will simply allocate the value to that variable. Na ganun din, every time you are declaring an object, halimbawa ito, you will be calling the or instantiating the object employee with a name, depende kung ano yung gusto nyo, some employee. So, ibig sabihin, you're instantiating that. And so in this statement, it can only be any legal identifier, this one, but objects conventionally start with a lowercase. So again, it can only be anything, pero it usually starts with a small letter. Tandaan po natin yun, ha? We have to remember that part kasi para hindi tayo ma little later on. Okay? Next here is ito, when you declare an integer, so for example, yung int some value, you notify that the compiler that an integer named some value will now exist and you reserve computer memory for it. So, just like the way on how we declare variables, ganun din po ang concept sa pag-declare ng isang class. So, for example, ito, we can just simply declare here an employee class with a name some employee, and from the some employee, will now instantiate an object employee. Pero, two lines kasi ng code to eh. What if gawin na lang natin one single line? So, you can do that by simply converting that into one single line. Again, etong employee word na po ito, ito yung class name na ginawa natin. So, this one and this one should be the same. Depende kung ano yung class name na pinangalan natin kanina. So, employee and some employee are the same. Take note. Okay? I mean, the new employee are the same. So, this one, it can be depende kung ano ang magiging sample natin or ano ang magiging pangalan ng employee mo. Okay. So, let's take a look here sa code natin. Sabi ko nga, hindi pa gagana yan kasi wala pang main method. Now, this part of the code here will now simply create a main method. Let's try to do that and let's try to understand kung paano nga ba gagana ang isang entire object. Ito object to eh, itong mga to. This is an entire object. And this object here has a data fields or attributes na tinatawag natin. And subukan natin yung pagganahin. So, let's create here let's say test employee. Yan. Test employee na class. Tapos, gawin natin ito. So, you have here the employee, ha? Tapos, meron ka ditong test case or test employee. Usually, kasi kapag ka main method, nilalagyan ko ng test yan na dito. Pasa word the test doon sa mismong ito. Okay? So, our favorite part of the code is, of course, the main method. Diba? And this time, gawin natin to. So, tatawagin ko ngayon si employee na class. And I'll name that as number one. Let's say an employee clerk, for example. So, I'll simply instantiate that by using the instantiate or the new keyword. Gawa pa tayo dito ng isa pang employee, which is the driver. Tapos, new employee. So, basically, tandaan nyo ha, ang ginawa lang talaga natin dito is simply set the attributes corresponding to the employee. Ano nga ba yung mga important na attributes ng employee? So, yung apat na yan. And for each attributes, we have created an accessor and mutator to that one. So, dito, kay clerk halimbawa, si clerk, from the employee na class, tatawagin ko si setEmpNum. Okay? Halimbawa, ang gusto kong value ni clerk here or employee number ni clerk is 123. Ayan. Tapos ang value ngayon ni or employee number ngayon ni driver is simply 457 5456 for example. Ganun siya. Tinawag ko tong dalawang or tinawag ko to sinet ko. Ito yung setters eh, taga-set, 'di ba? Ito yung taga-set ng ano natin. So, kapag ka ipiprint ko yan, tandaan nyo ha, setters yan. So, ibig sabihin, kung titignan natin to, kukunin ngayon ni value ni emp. Ito, tong 1, 2, 3, pupunta kay emp. Tapos, si empNum na variable, which is ito, kukunin niyo yung value ni emp, which is 1, 2, 3. So, ang value ngayon ni emp num will be 1, 2, 3. So, we can just simply call this method get emp num. So, kapag ka ipiprint ko yan, I can just simply put here, the clerk's ID number is plus get emp num. Ganun na siya. Or kulang, clerk.getEmpNum. Same goes through with the driver. The driver's ID number is this time you are calling the driver getEmpNum. Ganun lang. So, ang i-run natin, hindi ito, pero ito na. Tingnan natin. Boom! Ayan na po, diba? Nagpakita na. Nagets nyo ba? Nagets nyo yung idea ng object-oriented programming? I hope nagets natin, no? Kasi, awan ko ha, para sa akin, kasi syempre ginagamit ko to everyday. Eh. Kaya, napaka-linis, napakaganda ng code natin. Imagine mo yung main method, nandyan lang, di ba? Naka-separate lang. It's the way on how you organize the classes. And, just simply put anything beside. Di ba? So it's very clean. You can even for example, meron kang javax.swing dot yan JOption pane. Diba? So instead of you putting here like that one, pwedeng-pwede ka na ngayong gumawa dito ng variable kung saan mag-i-integer that parse in ka lang eh ang mangyayari diyan eh. Pwedeng-pwede mo rin gawin 'yon. Okay? So itong value kasi na to, so for example, int clerk, yan, is equal to integer that parse int j option pane that show input dialog null enter clerk ID number, for example. Diba? So, ganyan siya. Ngayon, itong si clerk_num, for example, dito mo ngayon yung pwedeng iba to kay clerk_num. So, every time yung nag-enter ka lang ng employee number, binabato mo yan dito kay setEmpNum. Pero again, ang employee number po kasi, once lang po nangyayari yan. Kasi nga, di ba parang ID nyo sa UC, ID number nyo sa UC, isa lang. It's unique. It cannot be changed at all. So, this is really nonsense na maglagay tayo ng input. Probably for the last name, pwede. Diba? So, if we will try to continue this part of the code, okay na to eh, established na to eh. Diba? So, this time, pwede na rin nating iset ang last name. Ayan. Pwede na rin nating iset ang first name. At pwedeng-pwede na rin po nating iset ang salary ni clerk. Ganon din kay driver, di ba? So, pwedeng-pwede mo na ngayon iset si last name ni driver. Pwedeng-pwede mo na rin iset ang employee first name niya. And at the same time, ayan, driver. So, dito, halimbawa, last name mo dito Uzumaki. First name mo is Naruto. Ang salary niya is, ano ang nilagay kong salary dito? Double. So, this should be double. So, 15. Tapos, dito is Uchiha. Dito is Sasuke. Tapos, dito is ganyan. Diba? So, nag-set ka na ngayon ng nakukompleto mo na, basically. Wala ka nang magiging problema dyan. So, kung kukompletuhin mo na yung program mo, it will now look something like this. Backslash n, full name. So, we have here, we will now be calling the clerk that get last name, or first name nila muna, get first name, followed by a space, followed by the clerk that get last name. So I can just simply copy this. Tapos i-convert ko lang into into driver. Driver is, this should be driver, this should be driver, this should be driver, and we should have here, hindi, wala na. Okay na, diba? So, the code is actually complete, and everything looks fine, and there you go, diba? So, napag-set mo na yung name niya, yung salary, kayo na bahala. So, pwede-pwede nyo na siyang gawin. Nagets ba natin ang part na to? I know, hindi pa yung iba sa inyo siguro, nahihirapan pang i-grasp yung idea na to. But then, that's the reason why I have also prepared yung part ng program natin or part ng module in which we call the You Do It. So, this is actually your chance para gawin tong part na to, So You Do It na to para mas maintindihan natin kung ano ang purpose or ano yung ginawa natin. Pero, for the sake of this example, I hope you were able to take a screenshot of the code. Yan ako na lang para ma-screenshot natin. Screenshot nyo na lang para kung sakaling gusto nyo i-revisit. Ayan. Teka lang, tanggalin ko yung mukha ko pag mag-i-screenshot kayo. Ayan. Screenshot yun na lang. Pa-zoom in. Sige. Full screen ko na lang. Anyways, nasa module naman ito eh. Ito lang ang hindi. Itong part, itong main method na to. Malabo ba? Hindi. Naka-ano naman ako eh. Naka high definition ako eh. Yung kanina. So, tige. Okay na. How about the others? Na-screenshot na? Sana na-screenshot yun na, no? Okay. Let's continue. So, alam na natin, di ba? Marunong na tayong gumawa nito eh. Ng ganito eh. By the way, kung nababother kayo na paganahin or magkaroon ng two different classes sa isang program mo, don't worry because basically, itong test employee na to, we can just simply delete them. Delete natin yan dito sa ito. Sa IntelliJ ko. Delete. And I can just simply place that. Oops. I can just simply place the employee. Where's the employee? Employee. Yan. What I can do here is to simply place anything inside the class. Pero after nito. Pero ito kasi magkaka-error yan. So, pwede natin tanggalin to. Gawin natin class. Ayan lang siya. So, take note ha. Ang ginawa ko dito, yung main method natin, nasa loob din pala ni mismong code. Diba? Sa mismong employee.java. So, you don't need, it's also possible for you to, of course, create one single Java class with everything already. But then, instead of us putting here public, wag na. Bakit nga ba nagka-error yan? Tingnan natin kung ano yung error. Pagka-error natin yan, ayun. The Java test employee is public, should be declared in a file name. Testemployee.java. Ayun yung sinasabi ko. Kaya nga yan, optional access specifier. In this case, the reason why it produced an error, it's because of the keyword public. It simply means that every time naglalagay kayo ng public keyword, in a main method, for example, you have to make sure na it is in separate, in a separate method. However, okay, in this case, since nasa loob kasi yan ng buong employee class mo, this should be not public, but rather just simply as is, as an entire class. Not unless this is the test employee class, this should be class this should be public naman. Okay? So, ganun yun. Ganun ang purpose nun. So, in this case, since employee.java yan, yung employee mismo dapat ang naka-public. Yan. So, nandyan yan, di ba? Pero para sa akin kasi, mas maganda kung naka-separate ang main method. Mas okay ko pa rin talaga. Any questions so far? None? Alright. I hope na iintindihan po natin to ha, kasi yung program, yung ang tawag dito, yung performance check nyo is actually 3 different programs, pero one entire class lang po siya. Mamaya, papakita ko naman yun. Okay? So, let me introduce here what we call the constructors. Constructors. Now, say for example, ito nga, you created an employee class na ginawa natin kanina, and instantiate an object with a statement such as the following. Ito, you are simply calling the employee class constructor that is provided by default by the Java compiler. By default, okay? Itong my new employee na yan. Now, a constructor simply establishes an object. And when we say default constructor, it is the one that requires no arguments. And a default constructor is created automatically by the Java compiler for any class you create. Kaya nga yun yung purpose ng new natin. So, when the pre-written default constructor for the employee class is called, it establishes one employee object with the identifier provided. Yung employee driver, employee clerk, for example. Diba? So, pre-written yun. And automatically supply default constructor provides the following specific initial values to an object's data field. Number one, the numeric fields are automatically set to 0. Okay? Number two, the character fields are set to Unicode, this one, or in other terms, this is null. Null. Okay? Boolean fields are set to false. And the fields that are object references, if for example, the string fields, are set to null or empty, such as this Unicode value. \u40. Now, if you do not want each field in an object to hold those default values, you want to perform an additional task when you create an instance of a class. So you can write your own constructor in which we will try to create as well. So any constructor you write must have the same name as the class it constructs. Now, if makikita nyo tong part ng you do it na to, this is basically the continuation of the previous you do it. But this time, yan, we added here the constructor public spa service with the following values already. Take note, with the following values. So, that's the spa service.java file. So, dito sa loob natin ng test. Kumbaga, ito yung test kasi. So, basically, this is the create spa services.java. So, yung next line na to, yung may input. Eh, kung ako sa inyo, gawin nyo na lang ito on your own para mas maintindihan natin. This is basically designed to for you guys to do sa part ninyo. Halimbawa kung, yun nga, wala na tayong klase. Parang bukas, di ba? We don't have class tomorrow. Now, we also have to understand that the classes are also data types. And the classes that you create become what we call data types. Classes. This one. The classes that we create here suddenly become data types. Yung mga int natin, di ba? Double yung mga ganyan. Kaya nga, take note, they actually become like para kang nagde-declare ng variable. Pero this time, you are trying to declare a class already with a constructor. Diba? Programmers sometimes refer to classes as ADTs or abstract data type. Yan. Kasi pag tinawag natin abstract, diba? Meaning it doesn't have any values. Abstract, walang laman, walang abstract. Mahirap maintindihan, diba? And usually, in Java, an abstract data type is a type whose implementation is hidden and accessed through its public methods. A class that you create also can be a called programmer-defined data type. So in other words, it is a type that is not built into the language And a class is a composite type that is a class composed from smaller parts, from smaller different parts. Now, let's take a look here at the example. Subukan natin itong gawin. And tignan natin kung paano nga ba ito mag-work, most likely. Now, when you declare a primitive type object, you provide its type and an identifier. And when you declare an object from one of your classes, you do the same. And after each exists, you can use them in similar ways. For example, suppose you declare an int name, myInt, and employee name, myEmployee. And each can be passed into a method, returned from a method, or assigned to another object of the same data. Let's try to take a look here at the example. Ito. Hindi ko alam kung nakikita nyo on your end, no? Pero ito kasi na-code na natin to. Number one, we have here the import java.util scanner. Ano pong ginagawa nito? For user inputs. So, meaning, balak mo na ngayong magtanong. Diba? Balak mo na ngayong magtanong kung ano ang input. Try na lang natin itong gawin, no? On our own. From ground up tayo para mas maintindihan natin ang code without... Yan. Mas maganda talaga. I-ground up ko na lang ito. Total memorize ko din naman yung code. Okay. Let's create here a class with a name methods that use an employee. This should be ganyan. Tapos meron tayo dito import java.util.scanner. So inside this one is ito, this time inuna ko muna si main method, di ba? Because this is actually the part where we will instantiate an object, my employee. Itong my employee na to, we will simply be creating another class with a name myEmployee. And for the myEmployee, and I can just simply call here the method getEmployeeData and particularly display the employee in that way. Pero kung napapansin nyo kasi error pa siya, diba? It's still because wala pa naman siyang laman. What we have done here is by simply created a class with a method already. So, syempre, kulang pa yan. Gawa ngayon tayo dito sa baba ng main method ng public class static employee tapos get employee data. Ayan. So, create ko na siya, diba? Ganon din dito sa public static, this time it's void display employee. Ayan. So kung napansin nyo, everything here or the error here was removed because based on what we have done earlier. Employee, my employee. Alright, so tama naman. Pero may error pa siya, di ba? Mamaya, makikita naman natin niya kung bakit. Okay. Now, if you will notice here, the value that is actually being returned here is assigned to my employee object. Nandito yan sa my employee object. So, the my employee object here is also being passed to display employee method, which is ito. And for this part here, the static employee, it has a return type of an employee. Okay. Which will now eventually, the purpose of this method is by simply asking the user to enter the employee number and the salary of that employee number. So, gawin natin yan. Employee. Gawa tayo dito nun yan. Yung temporary employee, which is ganyan. Yung temp m na yan, kahit wala pa yan eh. So, we have here the ID. We have here the salary. Ito, iba itong ginagawa natin. Hindi ito yung parang kanina. Ano lang to, different version or different way Yan, pero kasi ito this time with scanner na eh. So system.out.println, enter employee ID. Yan. Let's put that into ID. Input.next int. Let's place that into the typeemp set emp num ID. Ayan. So, nilagay ko lang dyan dito sa set emp num. And let me ask for the salary. Employee salary. Oops. Input. Ano to? Input.next in. Yan. Tapos, ilagay ko rin ito kay tempemp set emp salary, which is the sal, and return the tempemp. Ano ang nire-return natin dito, by the way? Kung nagtataka kayo. Ang nire-return po natin dito is simply the employee object. We are simply returning the entire employee object here. Ano nga ba yung employee object? Ito po. Itong employee object na to. Whatever the value that we have put here in ID and double salary will now eventually be returned. Take note ha, mare-return at mare-return po yan later on. Okay? So, ganun din dito. Kapag ka sa public static void display employee, we are just simply putting here a parameter, for example, an emp. Ito. This is a parameter eh. Kasi, kung may kapansin nyo dito sa method na to na tinatawag natin sa main method, it includes a my employee, an object. Ano nga ba yung object na yun? Kung ano yung ni-return mo dito. Tandaan nyo ako, ano yung ni-return nyo dito? Yun yung object na ibabato mo dito kay display employee. Kasi this time, ang nire-return natin are not values, but rather the entire method itself. The values inside the method. So, this time, kung ipiprint natin yan, system.out.println, ayan, employee number plus and emp dot get emp num, ayan, automatic nang nag-set, di ba? Hindi na tayo nag-set get kanina na parang isa-isa. This time, automatic na. Plus, backslash n, salary is, plus an employee that get emp salary. Okay. Ganyan na siya. So, ang i-run natin yan. Ayun. So, diba kung i-run natin yan, meron na siyang ganyan. Salary. Yan. Pero, syempre, may error pa yan. Mismatch exception. This is in number 20, which is ito. Ah, okay. Salary here should be double. Sorry. So, this should be double. Okay. Ulitin natin. Enter employee number. Employee salary. Ayun. O, diba? Maybe nagtataka kayo, bakit hindi na tayo gumawa ng employee na object? Diba? Bakit nga ba? Bakit nga ba? Ba't na hindi tayo gumawa? Kasi, number one, the employee here, the employee that Java earlier is already included, or it is already created earlier, kung natatandaan nyo, di ba? We already created the set, the accessors and mutators earlier, so that every time na i-gagawin natin yan or mag-iimplement tayo ng panibagong code that uses the employee, this entire employee class, mas madali na. Diba? Kung napansin nyo kasi kanina, Nag-ano tayo eh, itong part na to, itong pinakaunang ginawa natin, we just simply set the methods, the data fields. We expected that the data fields are actually being set, or their attributes are being set inside the employee. Ganun ka-powerful po itong employee class na ginawa natin. Just like how we are using the system object. Diba yung pinakita ko kaninang sample natin, yung system na to? Pag-clinic natin yan, ayan, magpapakita. Same concept po yan, guys. Same concept yan. We are just simply borrowing the keyword system, yung word lang na system. Pero yung word na system, it contains a lot of methods inside that. Especially yung out, tapos yung print line. Same goes through in what we have done here with the employee. So in this case, we have instantiated an employee object, which is ito. Diba? Pero this time, we are now calling the my employee and get employee data method, which is ito. Ang ginawa lang nito basically is simply ask the user to input the data of an employee and just simply display the whatever value nilagay mo dito. So kung i-organize natin yun ng maayos, ayun. Diba? Ang main method natin, ganyan lang talaga siya ka-exe. Diba? Very, very strong. Ganyan lang. Diba? Nagagets ba natin ang idea ng object-oriented programming? Sana talaga magets natin, no? Kasi it's really powerful and this is actually the most important thing na ginagawa sa any programming language that we have. Do you have some questions so far before we continue? Yeah, magkadugtong po siya. 'Di ba? Magkadugtong lang siya. Okay. So, let's proceed with a sample problem here that is somehow related to your activity. Uy, bakit nakikita yung green screen ko? Yan. Create a class name sandwich. Ang pangit. Class name sandwich. The data fields include a string for the main ingredient, such as like tuna, a string for bread type, and such as sweet, and a double for price, such as $4.99. It includes methods to get and set values for each of the fields, and you have to save the class as sandwich.java. Ayan. So may mga ganyan po tayong magiging problem. 'Di ba? So the number one thing that you have to do is actually to create or think of the sandwich first. Not the literal sandwich, but the sandwich object that we have. Okay? You have to think, ano nga ba yung mga components or particularly attributes na meron si sandwich? Okay? So let's proceed with the code. Number one, we have here a public class, sandwich. Pa? And according here, the sandwich should have the main ingredients. Ayan. Such as tuna. So I should name this as main ingredient. That's the first data field. Yun yung clue eh. A string for bread type. So that's another data field. Mahal ba yan? And a double for price, which is another data field, such as $4.99. So, para gawin natin yan, everything should be public. Kasi, bakit nga ba? Main ingredients can be changed, technically, in a sandwich. Kasi depende, di ba? Main public string, main ingredients. Public string double, I mean public double price. Yan. So you have the three. All right. So first of all, let's create the public string. Ano to? Get main ingredients. Yung getters natin. Let's return them. Oops, return main ingredients. Diba? So, nire-return natin yan. Pero, syempre, gawin din natin si set. Set main ingredients, in which will basically get whatever values you have called in a name, and will get the value of main ingredients to name. Okay. So, wala ka ng problema sa ano. Mas maganda kung lagyan natin ng comment dito. Main ingredients. Tapos dito, oops, let me put here the bread. And let me put here the price. Ayan. So dito, we have here the public. What's the data type for the bread? A string, di ba? So public string get bread. One related problem. No. Wala pong magiging problem yan. Get bread. Tapos sa loob nito, we can just simply return the bread. Tapos public void set bread. Tapos sa loob nito is string ulit. String bread name, for example. Gawin natin tong bread is equal to bread name. So, wala ka ng problema dyan, na? Working na yan. Next, here is lastly the price. For the price, since that's double, then get price. And return the price. Public. Then gawin natin si setter. Set price. With. Ano to? Should be double. Price number. For example. Oops. Hindi yan ganyan. That should be like that. Ano yung variable natin dito? Price lang. Price is equal to price number. Yan. So, ginawa na natin, di ba? Working na po. Hindi pa yan working, pero technically, this should work because we already have set the data fields for the class sandwich. We already have created the methods, the accessors, and mutator methods. So, okay na, di ba? Now, let's take a look at the number two problem. Create an application named test sandwich that simply instantiates one subject, one sandwich, and demonstrate the use of the set and get methods. So you have to set or save the application as testsandwich.java. So I have already prepared here a test sandwich Java. I-ano ko lang, i-redo ko lang ulit. Oops. Dito lang natin yung gawin. Ayan. So we have here sandwich and the test sandwich. Ayan. So basically what we are trying to do here is to create or instantiate an object. Okay. So this should be the name public class test sandwich. Public static void main string. Ayan. So, instantiate, number one, we instantiate or we call the sandwich class by simply putting here sandwich, sandwich. Take note, the name here can be anything, diba? That can be anything. So, in this case, gusto ko lang ganyan. Equals new sandwich. Like that. Diba? So, tawagin natin si sandwich ngayon. Let's set the main ingredients as tuna. Let's now call the bread. Ano ang ano ni bread? This should be string. Ano yung sa problem natin? The main ingredient should be tuna. The bread should be wheat. Diba? So, this should be wheat. Ayan. Tapos, sandwich, that's set. Ano yung isa-set ko dito? Set price. Ano yung set price natin? $4.99. So, if that is $4.99, you can just simply put that like that. Or, kung gusto mo, ganyan. Walang problema. So, if we would like to print that, system.out.println, we can just simply place here, you have ordered a number one sandwich dot get main ingredients, okay, plus sandwich on wheat. So kunin natin si sandwich dot get bread. Ganda ng code. Plus bread, and the price is, let's get the sandwich dot get price. As simple as that. So if we will run this very very easy program, oh yeah, na the class text sandwich is public, should be declared as blah 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 blah. Asan yung console ko? Ayun. You have ordered a tuna sandwich on wheat bread. And the price is $4.99. May kulang pa. Lagi ka ng ganyan. Para naman kahit pa paano eh, social. And the price is, dapat nga dito pala yan. Diba? Huwag na to. Ayan. This is an example, some, you know, this is an example program that answers the problem earlier, which is very easy. Diba? Pero ganyan talaga, kasi sample ni teacher madali, ang activity ni students, advance ng konti. It's automatic. So, you have ordered a tuna sandwich and a wheat bread, and the price is $4.99. Any question? It's a sample problem, by the way. So, I really suggest and I really encourage everyone to create or do this part of the code para po mas maintindihan natin or magkaroon pa tayo ng deeper knowledge sa part na to. Okay? So, for the written work, I guess I have placed them already in your Canvas. Yeah? So, you can already perform or do the written work. That's only a multiple choice naman, so you can go ahead and do that. As honest as possible, of course. And for the performance check, this is actually easy but then confusing because you already know the basics on how to create a program or a class. You already know how to create a class, eh? You also already know how to declare or instantiate a new object. Alam niyo na rin mag-set and get. Pero this time, yeah, you have to create a Java class named Working Student that has a fields for an ID number, number of hours, and number of points. Now, for example, many universities compute grade point averages based on a scale of 4. So, when we say 3, okay, 3 credit hour in a class in which a student earns an A is worth 12 points. A is worth 12 points. Include methods to assign values to all fields. Yan. A student also has a field for grade point average. Ayan yung mga binabanggit kong data fields natin, di ba? Include a method to compute the grade point average by dividing the points by credit hours earned. Write the methods to display the values in each student field and save this class as working student at Java. So that's only the first one. Yun yung pinakauna lang. Pero, this time, the number two problem here, you have a show working student Java program that instantiates the student, this one, from the class you created and assign values to its fields. Compute the student grade point and then display all the values associated with the student. Let me go ahead and show you the output. Pero syempre, hindi ko ipapakita yung program. Teka, itaas ko lang. Baka kasi makita nyo yung sample code ko eh. I mean yung sagot. Nandito kasi yung sagot. Ayan. Oops, nakikita. Ayan. Hindi na. Okay, so this is the show student. Or show working student at Java. And the student ID here is depende kung ano yung sinet ko dito. Diyan ako nagset eh. Diba? Or rather, dito ako nagset. Ito lang yung taga-get na methods. Yung parang ginawa lang din natin kanina, di ba? So, the hours here, you have three different hours. Ayan. And the points is additional, I mean, naging 12. It's basically the grade point average is 4.0. Ayan, parang ito. Ang skill kasi natin, ang 3-hour class, ayan, naka-earn siya ng 12 points. And so on. Now, for the computation of this one, bigyan ko kayo ng clue dito. Ang technique mo dito na gagawin for the working student, pag nagsiset ka ng oras, okay, pag nagsiset ka kasi ng oras dyan, you have to make sure to set the hours and you have to set the points itself. Yung points natin na, yung nakita nyo kaninang points na 12, kayo ang magsiset nun. Wala talaga kasi munang calculation na mangyayari. Kasi, doon lang ha, doon sa setting lang ha, ng hours and points. May mangyayari lang na calculation pagdating dito sa may grade point average na tinatawag. Okay? Yung sa mismong grade point average. Alright, so, yun. That's the first problem. Doon sa grade point average. Now, the question here is, paano nga ba makukompute si grade point average? It's very easy. Kasi the grade point average is simply the points divided by the hours. So, if you have placed a 12, ayan, if you have placed a 12, binabasa ko yung question. Anyways, if you have placed here a point which is 12 and an hour which is 3, definitely the grade point average is 4. It's very basic lang. It's simple division. So, you can perform this division inside the get method. Ano pong module yung isang activity? This one? This is module 3. Yeah, this is still module 3. Nagets ba natin ang grade point average? So again, ang hours dito, depende. Kayo ang maglalagay. So if I placed here an hour like 6 and points like 30, the grade point average is definitely 5. So that's the problem number 2. Now, for the problem number 3, itong show working student 2 na problem natin, take note that once you have like created here, ipakita ko lang yung ano. Create a constructor. Ayan, a constructor for the student class you created. And the constructor should have like initialized the student ID number to 9999999. His or her points earned to 12 and credit hours resulting a grade point average of 4.0. Now, write a program that demonstrates the constructor works by instantiating an object and displaying the initial values. Napakadali din, di ba? Kasi ang gagawin nyo lang dito is simply show how the constructor is being made. Yan. So, I think it's really that easy because this time, gagawa na kayo ng constructor kung saan ang sample kasi natin ng constructor kung titignan natin maigi, punta tayo dito sa may ito sa sandwich program. Itong sa sandwich program natin. And so this is actually the output of the problem number 3. You have here the student ID 999, the hours, points is 2. But then, for the constructor, you can just simply place that dito sa sandwich. And you can just simply do something like that. And this time, pwede ka kasing gumawa dito ng main ingredients. Tapos the value here, which is something like that. Bread is tinapay, for example. Diba? Tapos price is 2.99. So it's actually the same idea. This is actually a constructor, by the way. Constructor. So the problem number 3 can simply shows how constructor is being called, most likely. Okay? So ganun siya, ganun yung mangyayari for the number 3. Pero ang pinaka-importante po ditong program is itong working student na Java na to. Because later on, the ID number of the student that you have placed here will actually be set and will be eventually get by the methods that you will create earlier. Ayan, pakita ko yung first part ng program. Ayan. Pakita ko yung first part ng program. Diba? Yan yung parang pinakaklo ko sa inyo. So, this is the constructor. This is the get ID number and the set ID number. It's very easy. Alright, any questions so far? Sakto, 11 na pala.